Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Ayat number 12. A'udzu billahi minasy syaithanir rajim. Innal ladzina yakhshawna rabbahum bil ghaibi lahum maghfiratun wa ajrun kabir. Inna indeed alladzina dosu yakhshawna fear Rabbahum their master bil ghaibi in the unseen lahum for them maghfiratun forgiveness wa and ajrun reward kabir big. Verily indeed those who fear their Lord in the unseen theirs will be forgiveness and a great reward and that is paradise.
Yakhshawna rabbahum bil ghaibi fear of their master in the unseen.
Even though he is unseen to the person, the believer still believes of his existence and all of his messages.
The angels that are always at our left and right and continuously recording every single thing that we do or say are unseen from us. The fear of angels recording prevent us from even doing things that are wasting our time with no benefits. If the believer is alone, he will not be doing any sins because of fear of the unseen master and angels, not because of people. Usually the fear of being seen by people prevented a person from doing bad deeds. When nobody is around, it is a test whether you still have yakhshawna.
From the beginning of this surah until ayah 11, Allah is showcasing His greatness and describing to us the situation in Jahannam to make us respect and fear Him. Here in ayah 12, He wants us to know that out of fear of Him will not go unnoticed.
Maghfirah, forgiveness.
He will erase away all our wrongdoings when we genuinely fear Him.
The fear that is preventing us from doing bad deeds, the fear that is making us faithful to Him. During our office working hours, we take breaks to perform our obligatory salah. When we fear Allah, even our employer will respect our commitment. Having our record completely clean because of His forgiveness is a very great deal indeed.
Our relationship to Him is between the slaves and the master. The master awarding us with paradise because we fear Him. Comparing to a human master having slaves, the more the slaves fear Him, the more egoistic this human master gets and the more sadistic he will become. Exactly the opposite of our true master of the heavens and the earth.
Ajrun kabir, big reward. If you work in a very small an unstable company, the bonus will be smaller than if you work in a very big and stable company. A third world country cannot reward you of your contributions the same as a first world country. The wife of a peasant husband will get less gifts compared to the wife of a king. Hence, when Allah mentioned that He will give you a big reward, it is tremendously big. Far bigger than anyone on earth. Being faithful to our master has far better reward than being faithful to our employer can give you. Other ayat mention that paradise is as big as the sky and the earth, meaning each person will get the sky and earth and anything between them. Imagine each person given the size of Milky Way galaxy as his or her own personal property. Your next door neighbor is a galaxy away. Another thing to note in this ayah, Allah mentioned maghfirah before ajrun kabir, forgiveness before great reward. As long as you still have sins, you are prevented from entering paradise. Allah completely erased our sins clean since we feared Him as our master by faithful to His commandments and stay away from His prohibitions. At the same time, always remembering Him, thinking of Him, daily connections with Him so that He will be very close to us. Hence, the reason people enter hell is because their sins have not been cleared. The fasik believers, that is, people who believe in the existence of God, the Creator, but on too many occasions are rebellious against God as the Master, which made their sins to accumulate more than their good deeds, will need to be cleansed of their sins in hell prior to entering paradise. These fasik believers will not be in hell for infinity.
The length of their stay or membership of hell depends on how much more sins are left to be cleared. Therefore, the forgiveness of Allah when we fear Him cleanses all our sins, bypassing from ever entering hell, denied from obtaining membership of hell.
You do not have the credentials to become a member of hell.